So today we're going to show you how to replace a crank assembly. Okay, so to take the crank out, it's a very easy job. The crank assembly is just held on by two long bolts here with a little lock nut on the back side. Just gonna take, you could take a regular Phillips head screwdriver. I'm using this a little faster. Just gonna take these out. So as I'm taking these bolts out, I keep my fingers over these two holes on this back plate, because there's two little lock nuts here that are real easy to fall out and loose. And we'll just set this aside. The next thing is to grab this little nylon sleeve and pull it off. So now that we've got our back plate off, we're simply going to push the two long bolts through that hold the crank assembly on. And now our crank assembly is ready to come out. Now, there might be a little rope wrapped around the crankshaft here. So sometimes I just find it, if I have to take the whole crank maybe and turn it back and forth a couple of times, and then you'll see the rope. Okay, now you can see I'm kind of working the rope out. There's a little knot at the end of it here. There we go. So now that we've got that out, we're just going to untie this knot, take the crank off, and just kind of do the reverse to put a new crank assembly back in. So one last thing I want to cover is, what if you can't get the crank out because the rope's wrapped around the crankshaft like you see here? And this sometimes happens if your old rope broke and you continue to crank it to get it open, but nothing's happening because it's broken and the rope is now wrapped all up around the crank like you see here. Well, the key is we're going to have to get all that rope off the crank assembly before you'll be able to pull it out of the umbrella. And it's not too hard to do. So what we're going to do is simply remove the light switch and the little light socket, and that will allow us to look inside there, reach in there with a tool and grab the end of this rope here. I like to use little hook tools like this. If you don't have one of those, a coat hanger with a little bend on the end like that works. Maybe even some thin needle nose pliers will work for you. And boy, if you have it, this little mechanics grab tool is a great little tool to do this with. They only cost a few dollars down at a home store. And they come in handy quite often when you press on the end here with your thumb. This end here lights up. It's got a little hook there. Great way to grab the rope and just pull it out one of those holes. You probably won't need that, but just thought I'd show it to you because it's just handy to have around anyway. So we'll just go ahead and we're going to remove the light switch and the socket so we can reach in there and grab the end of this rope right here and get it all off the crankshaft. So this electrical socket requires a very tiny Phillips head bit. I'm just using this. You could use a hand screwdriver, but you're going to need a small Phillips head bit. Those two screws come out and then just pops right out. Now, this light switch here we're going to have to remove as well. And you can do that with either a flathead screwdriver or something flat like a butter knife works real well. So I'm going to use this little flathead screwdriver to pop this light switch out. And now there's three wires on the back of here that we're gonna have to take off. One of those, the red one, the one in the middle, goes to our electrical socket here. Once those are off, you can now pull this out. So one of the red wires goes to the middle of the switch, and then the other red wire coming off the socket attaches to the brown wire in the umbrella with a round receptacle. That's the main power lead in the umbrella. So we just push those out of our way. So now that we have those two holes available to us, which are real close to the crank assembly, we'll be able to use that flashlight or one of those hook tools I showed you to reach in there and find into that rope and grab it and pull it out one of those holes. And then we can just get it off the crank by pulling on the rope. Sometimes you just have to pull. Other times it helps to turn the crank as you pull all that rope off of there, like you see here in the picture. Once we're done with that, you can take the crank out just like you've seen earlier in the video.